Supervolcanoes. Experts warn of new threat rising beneath U.S., a relative of Yellowstone. Scientists warn a distant relative of the Yellowstone supervolcano is brewing beneath the United States, an unearthed report reveals. Volcanic eruptions have troubled human civilization for millennia, such as the famous eruption of Mount Vesuvius in 79 AD, which buried the ancient city of Pompeii in meters of volcanic ash and pumice. Most recently, an eruption in Tonga in January sent ash 60,000 feet, 18,000 meters, into the sky and obliterated the volcanic island. The eruption, which killed at least 5 people, is described as a once-in-a-thousand-year event and is estimated to rank 5th on the Volcanic Explosivity Index. Meanwhile, the supervolcanic eruption measures 8 on the VEI, which is the highest possible value. The eruption occurs once every 17,000 years and is approximately 1,000 times more powerful than the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens, which was the deadliest eruption in U.S. history. There are about 20 known supervolcanoes on Earth, including Yellowstone in the U.S., Lake Toba in Indonesia, and Lake Taupo in New Zealand. A groundbreaking study in 2018 revealed new supervolcanoes may be brewing in the U.S. states of Massachusetts, Vermont, and New Hampshire. A 2016 paper initially concluded that there was active, independent upwelling of molten rock beneath the surface, known as the Northern Appalachian Anomaly. Scientists at Rutgers University used 2 years of data from a 2016 study to get a better picture of what was going on. Professor Vadim Levin, a geophysicist, "The upwelling we detected was like a hot air balloon, and we concluded that something was rising through the deepest part of our planet beneath New England. The region where they made their discovery is geologically stable and has no active volcanoes. Therefore, the buildup of magma is relatively recent in terms of Earth's geological processes, in other words, tens of millions of years." Professor Levin continued, "It will likely take millions of years for upwelling to reach its goal. The next step is to try to understand exactly how this happened." He added, "It's not like Yellowstone, but it's a distant relative in the sense that something relatively small, no more than a few hundred miles, is happening. The magma bubble may never rise to the surface. If so, it will likely take a very long time." Professor Levin told National Geographic in 2018, "Maybe it's not the time yet, or maybe it's too small and will never work. Come back in 50 million years, and we'll see what happens." Supervolcanoes occur when magma in the mantle rises to the Earth's crust but is unable to penetrate it. Pressure builds in a large magma pool and continues to grow until the Earth's crust can no longer withstand the pressure. This event can occur in the hot spot where the Yellowstone caldera is located, or in the subduction zone where Toba is located. When they erupt, they can cause long-term climate change and threaten species extinction. The eruption of Mount Tambora in 1815 caused the year without a summer, and was the most powerful volcanic eruption ever recorded in human history. With a recorded VEI of 7, the potential for any supereruption would be 10 times more powerful than Mount Tambora. The most recent supereruption was Taupo in New Zealand about 26,500 years ago. Much of New Zealand was affected by the ashfall, with an 18 centimeters layer of ash remaining on the Chatham Islands some 1,000 kilometers away. It's not yet clear how humanity will respond if a similar event occurs again, but scientists have indicated that we probably won't have much notice when the next super eruption is about to occur. Earth scientist Luca Carici said in a study published in PNAS last year. Our research also shows that no extreme events occurred before the super eruption. This suggests that signs of an impending super eruption, such as a significant increase in earthquakes or a rapid rise in land levels, may not be as obvious as depicted in the disaster films produced by the film industry. However, other analyses at Yellowstone suggest that the magma reservoir could reach eruptive capacity within decades, which scientists may be able to detect.